Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to demonstrate and describe about the components and different modules of the electro-hydraulic workbench. In this, we will explain how to use the electro-hydraulic workbench and how the different modules are installed, and we will also doing the explanations of the experiments as how to do experiment with this electro-hydraulic workbench. So the order code for this electro-hydraulic workbench is 19204246.2. So the hydraulic system basically works with the liquid, and in this you can use the 68 grade liquid hydraulic oil. In this, the oil will be filled in the power pack. With this power pack we are also providing with this. So the hydraulic motor and different components are installed to ready to use installed, and you can use the hydraulic power pack. This is the tank of 35 liter. In this you need to fill the about 35 liters hydraulic oil to do the experiments, and I also explain you about the all the modules and the, all the components of this electro-hydraulic workbench to how to use. This is also configured with the PLC IO module, so this will give you the better understanding of hydraulic systems that are using nowadays in the industrial purposes. So hydraulic system basically used in many objects where the high power demand are required. Hydraulic system basically similarly work as a pneumatic system to operating different cylinders, but in the hydraulic power this is the uncompressible liquid and uncompressible medium. So this uncompressible compressible medium affects the very larger force amount. So in the maximum and the large force modules and the large force movements and the actions, the hydraulic power pack and the hydraulic systems are required. So this is very necessary in the industrial purpose to understand the hydraulic processes, and by this hydraulic workbench students can easily learn the hydraulic process through the different combinations and different experiments provided with this kit. I will explain you about the different modules and all the components which are used with this hydraulic workbench. So we will start with the power supply panel. So this is the first module and the starting module of this system. In this there is a double pole MCB of 16 amperes are provided to provide 415 volts and to up to 415 volts. So we will work on the 220 volt as our power pack motor is of 220 volts. So this is the power pack output at which you can connect the connector of the ready to use and install connector of power pack motor to connect this. This is the on off switch to provide supply to the SMPS, and then the SMPS will convert the 220 volt supply to the 24 volt 2 ampere supplies. These supplies will continuously provided to all the panels distributedly, and this is the power indication here, pilot lamp, to provide the on indication of the power supply panel. Now moving on, the switch panel and the SMPS panel, in which the 24 volt DC supply bus is provided. So this is the distribution of 24 volt DC outputs, in which there are different toggle switches of 10 knobs. There are 10 toggle switches in different modes from 1 to 10. You can use the low and high input as per the requirement in the module. And this is the digital meter of 4 digit display of 7 segment, and this is the on off toggle push button switch, push button 2, push button 1. All the NO and NC components are provided, so you can use them as to provide the NO and as to provide the NC as your programming purposes. Now moving on to the PLC and IO panel. In this there is a PLC installed of 24 volt DC rating. The PLC has the 16 knobs of digital input and 14 knobs of digital output. The output and input terminals are provided on both the sides of panel. Also we are providing RS-485 communication panel terminals outside on the panel, inbuilt on the panel, to communicate the data logging and other systems with the PLC. So this is about the PLC panel. Also there is a connector slot provided to programming the PLC as per the required programs. This is the 24 volt bus. This will also providing the supply inside the PLC, and you can connect the output to the other panel also. Now moving on, this is the buzzer and indicator panel. So this is the buzzer and indicator panel. In this there are different lamps are provided to give the outputs of different modules, and the buzzer is also provided. This is the 24 volt DC buzzer, and 8 knobs of different 24 volt pilot signal lamp, and PNP IO inductive proximity sensor input also provided. You can use the PNP type of proximity sensor. These are the positive negative power supply terminals of the proximity sensor, and this is the output terminal of the proximity sensor. So you can connect the output from here, and after that you can use the pilot signal lamp as per the requirement. So this is the power pack module. In this, the power pack unit consists of 230 volt 50 hertz AC motor. The AC motor works on the 425 RPM, 1 HP motor, AC induction motor, which connected with the 3 LPM gear hydraulic pump. In this, the pump works with the 3 LPM flow, and the flow can be measured with the pressure meter provided over here. And also the flow control valve for the pressure here to use the pressure relief valve. And this is the P out terminal. From this, the pumped output will be provided through the quick release coupling hose pipes. And this is the tank input. So the release and the relief oil will be incoming to the tank from this. And this is the oil inlet valve. Here you can fill the oil by opening this valve. There is a gasket and the filter is also installed inside the oil tank. So the oil and the other dust particles will prevent to going from the in the inside the oil tank. And there is the oil level and temperature meter provided. So this will show when the oil is filled, the oil will be filled in the temperature meter also. And this will, there is a temperature thermometer installed inside this. So you will have to prevent the oil, do not heat up more than 85 degrees Celsius. So this is a temperature indicator also to providing and preventing the oil from the burst conditions. So this is all about the hydraulic power pack. This is the main unit to do the all hydraulic experiments. Now moving on to the different hydraulic components are provided here. So I will explain you with the hydraulic motor. This is the hydraulic motor of double connection bidirectional gear type hydraulic motor. So the input and output line are connected with this. This is the input line, and the direction of hydraulic motor should be in this direction, also provided on the panel. And in output from the hydraulic pump should be output from this. So when the hydraulic flow will be provided from this, the gear coupling inside the motor will run the shaft and the motor will work. You can use this motor as per your requirement to movement of any of the generator and other purposes, to of which works on the movement tree basis. So this is the basic work of hydraulic motor. Now moving to the double acting cylinder. This is the double acting cylinder with the stroke up to 10 centimeters, and this will work on the 100 bar pressure, up to 100 bar pressure. So double acting cylinder has the one input and one output valve and one outlet and inlet. So the quick release coupling can be connected with this. So hose pipe will be connected and pressured output will be provided through the this movement. And as the filled oil, hydraulic oil filled inside the chamber of the hydraulic cylinder, the piston moves forward. And when we provide the pressure from the forward side of the gauge, and so the pressure will fill and pull the piston inside again. So this works with the hydraulic pressures, and this is the basic purpose and functioning of the hydraulic cylinder. So hydraulic cylinder will, a piston will forward movement with the pressure. When pressure provide backside, the forward movement happens, and when pressure provide front side, the backward movement happens. Similarly, there is a single acting cylinder with spring return. So we have to only provide the pressure from backside, and this will again release the pressure. There is a spring installed inside the cylinder. So this will again pull back the piston to which is going to the forward. So after forward movement and pressure is released from the backside or back end of the cylinder, so the spring will pull back the cylinder. So we have to provide the pressure from only backside in this type of cylinders. Now moving on, this is the flow control valve. You can control the flow. So this is the input of the flow control valve, and the output you can use the A is the input and B as the output. And by this momentary and valve rotational movement, you can control the flow of the hydraulic oil passes through this flow control valve. After this, output can be provided as per the flow requirement to the cylinders and any other systems. Now moving on to the pressure gauge. This is the pressure gauge. Here you have to provide the hydraulic input. This will show the pressure and the output will be provided from other end. So the pressure will analogly shown on the dial gauge. So this is the pressure meter from 0 to 15,000 PSI, and from 0 to 100 bar you can use the pressure gauge up to 100 bar also. Now moving on, there we have a pressure gauge again to select the pressure accordingly for different type of cylinders. Now moving on, there is a proximity sensor also provided to do the study with the proximity sensor. This is the PNP type 8mm dia proximity sensor. The wiring is all connected, and this is the easy to movable proximity sensor. So you can use the proximity sensor from both the cylinders to operate as per the requirement at any position. So these are the positive negative and output terminals of the proximity sensors. Here you have to provide the supply 24 volt, and output will occur when the sensor says any metallic object. So at this time we can sense the cylinders, pistons. These are the metallic object, and any metallic object can be sensed by the inductive proximity sensors. Now moving on, we have a hand lever valve here. This is the spring return hand lever valve and directional control valve, the 4x3 directional control valve. In this we can use the directional control valve as required. These are the different ports of this directional control valve, also given on the sticker and shown on the sticker also. So this is the T and P. This is the tank input and pressure port. This is the tank port and pressure port, and this is the A or B port. These ports can be used as per the requirement. Now when we provide the pressure line to the P port and tank line to the T port, so when we do not have actuated the 4x2 hand lever valve, the pressure will be releasing from both the ends to the port to the tank, and the pressure will be going to the same direction from A and B. And when we actuate this by hand movement, this will extensively change the directions. So this will give the output. So output from the A will going to the tank, and output from the B will be going to the pressure port. So this is how the hand operated 4x2 hand lever valve works. Now moving on to the 4x2 solenoid control valve. In this there is a solenoid provided, which is the works on the 24 volt DC supply. As we provide the DC supply, the same operation as the hand lever valve will be happen, but in this case we have to provide the supply to this solenoid coil from any of the output provided on the PLC and other panels to controlling this. Now this is the 4x3 directional control valve. In this there are two solenoids, so this works with the two processes, and the 4x2 and a spring centered up to 350 bar 60 lpm. And this is the solenoid valve for first. T1, T2 terminals are the first solenoid valve terminals, and T3, T4 are the second solenoid terminals. So this will work when the directions changes in both the condition. When we operate the first directional for first solenoid coil of the directional valve, the first movement will be interchange the A or B port directions. In the first condition, the directions will be blocked. So the directions from port to tank will be continuously flowing, and A to B will be remain blocked. All the terminals are blocked when there is no actuation. When we actuate the first directional valve, the diagram shows that the port valve will be going to the B output and tank valve will be going to the A output. So this will open like this, and the pressure port will be flowing with the A output, and B will be release valve to the tank. So this is how the hydraulic work. And when we press the or operate the second valve, the second solenoid valve, the actions will be remain same. So in this case the port and the pressure port will be open to the A directions or the A port, and tank port will be with the B port. So the pressure and the oil will be flow from P to A, and for tank the B pressure, the B is the outgoing line, so the output line will be going to the tank to the release of the oil. So that's how the solenoid valve will working in the conditions of hydraulic. And you can do all the hydraulic experiments which are given in the user manual as explained. So the whole bench or the hydraulic workbench is situated with the portable table. In this, the four wheels are connected, so easily movement can be used and easily shifting can be easily occur with the wheels are instantly located. And also wheels are provided with the lock mechanism, so when you press and want to study the working, so this will be on the locking position, so there is no slip ring and other occur hazardous conditions occurs through with the lock mechanism. And we are also providing in the accessories, these are the quick release coupling. These are very handy to use while working with the hydraulic functions. So these are the quick release coupling, you can easily use them by pressing this. I will explain you how to use. So we will connect one end of this quick release coupling to the bar. So put this quick release coupling on the any of the port and press, pull this, and this will easily connect like this. So this is how we connect the quick release coupling, and the other end can be easily connected on while you can connect this to the cylinders. All the cylinders and other ends can easily be connected with this quick release coupling. So proper connect the quick release coupling for all the operations. These are different hose pipes are provided from of 1x4 inch in the dia and about 1 meter in the length. And also we are providing some patch cords for electrical connections in this handy case. So these are the different type of patch cords are provided with this to do the all experiment setups with this hydraulic workbench. And the user manual for deep study and to all the components which are installed with this hydraulic workbench and PLC and other terminals and experiments to do the practice of the hydraulic workbench are also provided in the user manual. And there is a compartment box also to place the user manual and other accessories to safely on the with the workbench, so there the hydraulic and the manual and the other accessories will not be lost. So this was all about the demonstration and description of different components and different modules connected with this and installed with this hydraulic workbench. So you can do all the experiments provided in the user manual. After filling the tank, properly clean the tank when you fill and do the connections. So you have to open the all valves to change the oil when the oil is dirty and are not in use. Always clean the tank and always use the dirty clothes and the rough clothes while working with the hydraulic system, as there is might chances of some leakages. So carefully use the QRC coupling hose pipes, so there will be no any leakages while working with the high pressure. Leakages can harm anyone, so while working with this hydraulic workbench, do and use the proper safety measures. And all the components are very fragile, so do not and try to be safe from the oil and other liquid forms which are to be splitting on the electronics components are provided on the upside of the table. So while doing the experiments, if you find any difficulties, you can contact Tuteska Technologies Private Limited for all the support. Thank you.